Hey Java developers, JDK 23 is set to be released today. Let's cover the 12, though not 13 JEPs included in this release in 2 minutes, more or less. JavaDoc now supports Markdown, specifically the upmark notation. This should help improve the readability of JavaDoc when viewed from a source code file. To use the Markdown notation, start the line with a triple backslash. Generational mode is now the default when using ZDC. Generational mode was added to ZDC in JDK 21. Single generation mode is still available and can be used with the JVM argument minus Z generational, but the plan is to deprecate and remove it in a future release. So get your migration plans in place. The memory access methods in sun-misc-unsafe have been designated for deprecation for removal. Please migrate towards the equivalent var handle and foreign function and memory APIs added in JDK 9 and 22, respectively. There were 8 preview JEPs included in JDK 23. JEP 455 introduces primitive types and patterns as a first preview. As the name suggests, the goal of this preview of this JEP is to allow developers to reference primitives, boolean, byte, char, double, float, int, long, short, and patterns, reducing the friction of using primitive values. The class file API has been re-previewed in JDK 23 with JEP 466. There are a number of changes to the class file API. Be sure to check the JEP for details. Stream Gatherers also enters second preview in JDK 23 with JEP 473. Stream gatherers aim to provide the new gather operation, an intermediate operation that gives developers considerable flexibility in transforming the contents of a stream. Basically, it is the intermediate version of collect. Module import declarations were introduced as a preview feature in JDK 23. Module imports allow the importing of all the public API of a module with a single line. This is useful for developers who might not be familiar with the JDK package structure are when working on greenfield development. Implicitly declared classes and instance main methods enters third preview with JEP 477. The primary goal of this JEP is about improving the experience of learning Java by allowing a smooth introduction of features like methods, accessibility, classes, and more. In this round of preview, there were 2 changes. Implicitly declared classes will automatically import the 3 public static methods located in the new Java IO class. And implicitly declared classes will automatically perform a module import of Java base. Structured concurrency enters a third round of preview with JEP 480. There were no changes proposed in this round of preview for structured concurrency. However, significant changes are coming in JDK 24. We'll cover all those changes when the Loom team publishes the updated JEP, so be sure to subscribe to this channel so you won't miss that video when it's published. Scope values were also re-previewed in JDK 23 with JEP 481. There was only one change in this preview. The type of the operation parameter of the method scope value call where is now a functional interface, which allows the Java compiler to infer whether a checked exception might be thrown. With this change, the method scope value get where is no longer needed and was removed. Flexible constructor bodies enters second preview in JDK 23 with JEP 482. As the name suggests, the purpose of this JEP is to loosen the restrictions when writing a constructor. The change in this revision allows fields defined within the subclass to be initialized before the explicit call to super. The only JEP that remains in incubator status is Vector API JEP 469, which will remain in incubator status pending at least the previewing of Valhalla features. For an update on Project Valhalla, watch this video from JVMLS. String templates was removed as a preview feature from JDK 23. This was the result of community feedback and internal testing. The JDK engineers plan to reintroduce string templates once they have had a time to develop a better solution in a future release. Well, that's it for the major changes coming in JDK 23. Be sure to join us for our JDK 23 launch live stream later today, link in the description. Also, come back Thursday where I will cover all the changes included in the JDK 23 release notes. Happy coding!